U.S. Air Force has signed its first contract for Joint Strike Missile, or JSM, cruise missiles. The Pentagon announced the U.S. Air Force's award of the JSM Production Lot 1 contract. It's a fixed-price deal with Norway's Kongsberg Defense, valued at $141 million. According to the Pentagon's daily contracting announcement, this contract provides for all up-rounds, containers, and test equipment for the Joint Strike Missile. Work will be performed in Kongsberg, Norway, and is expected to be completed by August 31, 2026. Importantly, the JSM is sized to fit inside the internal weapon bays of F-35A Joint Strike Fighters. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why F-35A with JSM would be a deadly combination. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Joint Strike Missile is a fifth-generation, long-range, precision-guided missile. The JSM is based on Naval Strike Missile, or NSM, and was developed by Kongsberg in partnership with America's Raytheon. It's capable of land attack as well as anti-ship missions. The development of the missile began in 2008 and was completed in mid-2018 after a series of validation test firings. It has a range of roughly 350 miles or 560 kilometers when using a normal trajectory, whereas it has a range of 175 miles or 280 kilometers when using a low-altitude trajectory. The JSM carries a 500-pound or around 225-kilogram warhead, making it powerful enough to neutralize most targets. It has an elaborate navigation suite that includes GPS, INS, and terrain mapping. The terrain mapping feature makes it possible for the missile to find its target even if the GPS navigation is jammed. In the terminal phase of the flight, it uses an imaging infrared, or IIR, seeker to home in on the target. The missile has a two-way data link throughout its flight. This allows it to be monitored continuously and gives the operator the flexibility to abort the mission or redirect the missile to a different target until the last moment. JSM is designed to be stealthy and very maneuverable, so it can approach its target from different paths, making it very hard to intercept. The Pentagon began the F-35 program in 2001 to develop a cost-effective replacement for the U.S. military's F-15 fighters, F-16 and F-18 fighter bombers and reconnaissance aircraft, and A-10 close-in support warplanes. The fighter is set to be the backbone of U.S. air power, as well as many allies. The F-35 has three main models: the conventional takeoff and landing, F-35A, CTOL, the short takeoff and vertical landing, F-35B, STOVL, and the catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery, carrier-based, F-35C, Kettlebar. F-35A has been operational with the U.S. Air Force since 2016, and a wide range of weapons are now certified to be used with this jet. F-35, being a fifth-generation fighter, is developed from the ground up to be stealthy. Its external structure is designed to deflect signals away from the emitting radar, which makes it hard to detect or track. This is done by having no sharp edges or protruding elements, and having a smooth external curvature. Also, it has a coating of RAM, or radar-absorbing material, that reduces the number of signals getting reflected. F-35 has the lowest radar cross-section, RCS, of all the jets except the F-22 Raptor. Against X-band radars, it's stealthy from the front and rear. Against S-band radar, it's stealthy from the narrow front aspect. Against L-band radar, the limited reduction is achieved from the direct front. Classified techniques have also been used to reduce the heat signature of F-35. This thermal profile management of the jet makes it difficult for infrared or IR homing missiles to target it. While the F-35 is capable of carrying weapons on its external weapons pylons under its wings, the ability to carry missiles internally would preserve its stealthy profile. Apart from F-35A, JSM can be integrated inside F-35C, but not inside F-35B, which has a smaller weapons bay. Kongsberg has also carried out fit checks that have demonstrated the ability of the F-16 Viper, F-A-18E and F Super Hornet, and F-15E Strike Eagle, as well as the F-35A, B, and C, to carry JSMs externally. Once air dominance is established, the F-35s could carry JSM externally, which enables greater loadout. It's not a secret that air superiority is the key to modern warfare. To counter Western aerial domination, countries like Russia and China have deployed sophisticated air defense systems as part of the anti-access and area denial, or A2AD, strategy. Russia has deployed S-300 and S-400 and is in the process of operationalizing the S-500. China has HQ-9 and HQ-12 SAM. These weapons could inflict a huge amount of damage to aerial assets like fighters, bombers, aerial tankers, and airborne warning and control system aircraft. Non-stealthy aircraft are very vulnerable. This is where F-35A, with a missile like JSM tucked inside its bay, can be very handy. F-35As with JSM could penetrate deep inside enemy territories and land the initial punch by decimating critical military assets like air defense systems, weapons depots, and command and control centers. The Ukraine-Russia conflict has shown that even the most sophisticated air defense can be neutralized with proper planning and correct weapon selection. It's unclear how many JSM would be acquired. The service has said in the past that it was planning to buy 48 JSMs in Lot 1 and that it could acquire up to 268 of them in total.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.